Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, let us discuss the angular displacement of the body moving in a circular path. So let us start with angular displacement. Hello students, now we will discuss about angular displacement. Angular displacement is basically that when the body moves in a circular path, suppose that this is a circle and the body moves starting from any point you consider. Suppose the body is here at any time. Now it is moving, say, in anti-clockwise sense, and it moves from one to any position two in suppose any time, say t. In time t, it moves from position 1 to position 2. Now in this situation, see, this point is suppose 1, it's a, this point is now say b, this point is suppose o. Now what happens is that when the body moves along the circumference, along this path only it will move. When it moves along this path, what is changing is this distance is not changing because it is moving in the circle and the radius remains constant. So this distance OA and this distance OB will remain same. So what is changing then? How to describe the motion if the distance is constant, always remains constant? If it moves from here to any position, say C here, then also its distance, linear distance, will not change. Then how you describe the motion? This is described by angular terms. That is, here the displacement is not linear, we'll define in terms of angular position and the angular displacement. This position, where at any time suppose the particle is at this point A, at any other instant it is at B, similarly at any other instant it might be at C or any point on the circumference, that position says the angular position of the particle. So if this is the position, then this is always taken as the reference line. This horizontal line is called as the reference line, and with respect to this reference line we always measure the angle. If it is at exactly 90 degree position, then we say that when it is at C, the angular position is pi by 2 radian. Here we'll measure angle in radian. We know that 180 degree is pi radian and 90 degree is pi by 2 radian. So when the particle moves from position 1 to position C, it describes an angle equal to pi by 2 radian. So this position is pi by 2 radian, this position is 0 radian, it can be any other. If it is exactly at the opposite end of the diameter, suppose this point is D, then this position corresponds to 180 degree or pi radian. So that is the angular position. Now, angular displacement is the change in the angular positions. That means if a particle moves from point say A position to say B position in time suppose t, though time is not required for displacement here, but if I say that time is t is the time taken to move from point A to point B, then the angle that is described here, suppose this angle is theta, then that angle theta is the angular displacement. So this is the angular displacement. If it moves from, so here, suppose I will call this as a 1, theta 1, to distinguish this. So from A to B, the angle traveled is theta 1, so that is the angular displacement. Suppose I will take another case that B to C, it is moving, and in any other time, suppose T prime, so it is moving from, say, position B to position C, here to here, in time, suppose T prime. How much time it takes from here to here? It takes time T. This angular displacement during this time interval is theta 1. Similarly, for this position, when it is finally here at C, the angular position is suppose theta 2, though it is 90, but I write theta 2. So from B to C, what is the displacement? Displacement is this one only. So the displacement is this one. Here also the displacement is this one. So this is the displacement because the body gets displaced from this position to this position. So this is the angular displacement. And you can well define this angular displacement. Suppose this angular displacement is theta, then obviously that theta is nothing but this angle minus this angle. So here it is theta 2 minus theta 1. That is the angular displacement. Though I have denoted this as only theta. So similarly, that means the change in, what is this? This is a change in angular position. When it is a C, the angular position is theta 2. When it is at B, the angular position is theta 1. What is the change? The final value minus initial value, this is the displacement. Okay, so the angular displacement is defined as it is a change in the angular position. Okay, so this theta 2 minus theta 1 is known as the displacement. You can denote this as theta or d theta, whatever you like, but that is the, and what is the unit? This is the definition of this. What is the unit of that? The unit of this, suppose this is a theta. What is the unit of theta? This is a radian. You must take note that 180 degree is pi radian. This is an SI system, and the symbol you are using for this is RAD. Okay, this is the symbol used. Now, what about the quantity? What about the quantity? Which quantity? Angular displacement. Whether it's a vector scalar or which type of quantity. Now we have got two things. This angle theta, which is angular displacement, it is it can be a vector. It can also be a scalar. Now, when it is behaving like a vector quantity, when the angle is very, very small, so very, for very small angular displacement, when the displacement is very, very small, then it is a vector quantity. When it is a large value, when theta is large, it is a scalar. When it is large, it is a scalar quantity. So when it is a small one, it is a vector quantity. So we write that infinitesimal small angular displacement is a vector quantity finite angular displacement is a scalar quantity. The reason is very simple, that at small angle or small change in angle, the quantity obeys the laws of vector addition, that is, it is following the law commutative property of vector addition. That means if theta 1 and theta 2 are small angles, then theta 1 plus theta 2 can be written as theta 2 plus theta 1. That means theta 1 plus theta 2 is equal to theta 2 plus theta 1. Then it is a vector quantity. If theta 1 plus theta 2 is not equal to theta 2 plus theta 1, then it is a scalar quantity. So that we can demonstrate using we can explain that using I'll take one example to explain, to justify that if I take small angles, then it is a vector, and that means say theta 1 plus theta 2, whatever orientation I will get, then theta 2 plus theta 1, I will get the same orientation, same vector I will get. So therefore they are equal. Now, before that, we'll also think of the, if it is a vector, then, but whether it is scalar or vector, we must take note that in both the situations, it has got magnitude, that means angular displacement has magnitude, and as well as it has directions. So both these are there, but it doesn't obey the, in case of scalar quantity, it doesn't obey the law of vector addition. So if it is vector or it has direction in any way, then how to find the direction of a particle moving in a circular path? So obviously, we use a right-hand thumb rule. So what is that right-hand thumb rule? That will write here. Now, in angular displacement, we have got the direction is found using the direction of theta. That is angular displacement. If a body moves in a circular path like this, and the particle is here, then the right hand thumb rule is that this is the right hand, and fingers except the thumb, the curved fingers must be pointed in the direction of the sense of rotation. The body is moving in this fashion, that is in anti-clockwise sense. So the curled fingers must be in the direction of anti-clockwise sense. So the body is moving in this sense, I'll keep my fingers in that sense, that in that directions. Then this one, the thumb must point the direction of angular displacement. So if it is clockwise, then the fingers will also be in the clockwise sense, and this one is the, this direction is the direction of the angular displacement, which is the axial vector, that is, it is, direction is always along the axis of rotation. When a body is moving in this circle, then its axis is in this direction. So if it is anti-clockwise, the displacement will be upward. If it is clockwise, the displacement will be downward. So in this situation, it is upward. Anti-clockwise sense, it is upward. So this is the direction of theta. If it is clockwise, it is downward. That figure also I will draw here. Suppose it is moving clockwise, then this is the direction of theta. Okay, that is fine. So in any orientation you can take, depending, and put the curl fingers in the sense of rotation, and this thumb outstretched thumb will directly give you the direction of angular displacement. Now this is this rule is known as the right hand that I told you, explained to you, the curved fingers in the sense of rotation and the outstretched thumb will give you the direction of angular displacement. Now, this is all about your angular displacement. Now, we will go to the next topic in the next video. For the time being, thank you very much.